are, folks, at the Toronto Maple Leaf Gardens. This, to me, is the greatest shrine of all hockey. I remember the first time I came here, I was 14 years old. I was playing Junior B hockey for the Kingston Victorias. I really thought I was something. The first time I skated out on here was unbelievable. The thing I remember most, ice was all white. You know, when back in Kingston it was dark, it was white. It was just beautiful. And the next time I remember I was on was Junior A hockey with the Barrie Flyers. We used to come in here on Sunday afternoons, we'd have 16,005, more than the Leafs the night before. You couldn't get a ticket in the place. And the best thing I remember, we won the OHA championship right here, beating the Toronto Marlboros. It was something. This is the greatest bill in the world as far as I'm concerned for hockey. And I'll tell you, one of my favorite guys of all time, Major Conn Smythe, built this in the Depression, if you can believe it, in the 30s. And you know what Mr. Smythe said? If you can't beat him in the alleys, you won't beat him on the ice. And he was right. Let's go. Not only do these hits look hard, they sound hard. Take a listen. You know, when I'm talking about tough guys, I'm talking about the guys that go into the corners first. They're the ones that pay the price, right, Yanny? Get up, that a boy, Yanny. Look at these guys working in the pitch. These guys are real hockey players. You know, there's nothing better than watching goalies rob players of sure goals. Starting with my buddy Grant Fuhr. Something the fans in Edmonton are going to miss Cujo. The Oilers lost is the Leafs game. What a battle! This is war. Avalanche need a goal to tie it up. And they didn't, and Claude seems a little upset. You know, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. And Cujo is lucky and he is good. Just a little love tap. Byron is one of the reasons Boston did so well last year and Pat Burns won Coach of the Year. I can't believe it. And now watch Eddie the Eagle fly. Hey, don't get in Eddie's way or you're gonna get it. Sub, he uses that blocker for more than stopping pucks. One of my favorite games of all time here was when I was coaching the Boston Bruins and we were going for first spot. We had to win the last four games to clinch first over Buffalo. We were losing 5-3 to the Leafs with 1:30 to go, but Matty Hagman makes it 5-4. The next shift, Wayne Cashman digs a puck out of the corner. Dougie Howard comes in and ties up the game. Boy, it was getting exciting. Two shifts later, Donnie Marcotte scores to give us a 6-5 lead, and then Ricky Smith scores in the empty net to clinch the game 7-5. Oh, boy, were we excited. Hey, I'll tell you a funny story about that one. The Sabres GM punched in like, hey, you know what he did? He left the game with 2 minutes to go, thinking he was in first place. When he got to his car, the car attendant said to him, geez, that was a tough Leaf loss. They punched Clark says, what are you talking about? Leafs won. And the attendant says, the Bruins won 7-5. And you know, folks, we went on to clinch first spot. And of course, you remember the time we broke the record for 20 or more goal scorers in one season. Here's Bobby Miller breaking the record. And I'll tell you, folks, life was beautiful. Now watch the Russian rocket pop some in. Hey, I'll tell you, they don't call him the Russian rocket for nothing. Watch him fly. Watch this beauty backhand. And here's some more nice backhands, first by Bill Guerin. My buddy Joe Sakic. You know, this summer I told rookie Joe Thornton when he scored his first goal in the NHL, I'd get it on my tape. Hey, Joe, there's more of those to come. Here's Eric in the playoffs. And here's Captain Matz. Sorry, not the playoffs. Hatcher with a beauty. I call these roofers. I love these coaches. They're what I call alive on the bench. Scotty's saying, it's a dive, it's a dive. Look, it's a dive. Pat firing it off the bench by getting mad at Paul Stewart. And keep your eye on Joe Thornton. He never saw anything like this in junior. Attaboy, Pat, that's why you won Coach of the Year. He's in the game. Hey, here's my buddy Joe Quenneville. He seems a little upset. Hey, he learned that good form and how to coach from a great coach who coached in Colorado. Ronnie Lowe and Mark Crawford get it going in the playoffs. Watch Ron throw his gum. Hey, these guys aren't fooling around. That's what I like, these coaches. They're in the game. You gotta have your head up on the bench because you never know who's gonna drop in. Hey, Arvidsson tries to knock Randy McKay, my buddy, into the bench, and Randy comes out saying he's not gonna take that stuff. Let's go, let's go. You wanna go? Keep your head up. This is what I call getting benched. Even the linesmen have to keep their head up. Look out for the door, Captain Keith. You know, you even have to keep your eye on your own teammate. Al McInnes break Trottier's finger on this play. Boy, Al was so upset he wouldn't go back on the ice. Now watch these beauty hip checks. How many times have I told you not to cut in the center ice? And here's why. Marcus Olin didn't learn his lesson. He got zonked twice this year cutting across the center. Look out, Kasparaitis. Here comes Ty. It's turtle time. It was the year of the goalies, and Hasek and Kolzik were the best. Watch these beauty stops by Hasek. I don't know how he does it, but he does it. Sabres and Hasek met their match in Ole Kolzik, otherwise known as Godzilla. To be a good goalie, you have to play on the edge, and Dominic Schur shows his emotion. I don't know why he was mad here. He made the save. But I sure know why he's mad here. Sometimes goalies are nice to each other and play a nice game of catch. And sometimes not. Now the goalie fight of the year, Pat Roy and Chris Osgood. They can throw them so good with all that equipment on. I don't know, but they sure do. Mikey Vernon's at the bottom of this pile, and here comes Cujo. You know, oh, somehow I don't think these guys are too serious. They're saying, hey, Mikey, how about we dance here? They really don't want to throw them. You can see that. And here comes the ref saying, hey, come on, you guys, quit laughing. This is serious stuff. And Cujo says, sorry, ref. And tries to act mean. Right here on this spot, Bill Barocco scored one of the most exciting goals of all time. I remember he put it in the top corner on Jerry McNeil to win the 51 Stanley Cup. Now here's some OT goals from last year. Rune versus the Pens. Barasa didn't even see it. Sakic versus the Oilers.
a zinger home. Oh, he seems to be doing that. Mike Keane versus the Sharks. Nice pass and in. Hogue versus the Oilers. Top corner. Langdon Bruner on the wings. Chris Belt back after this one. Got a shutout the next game, just like I predicted. Sanderson on the halves. Boy, this is a killer for Montreal. Should have won this game. Hasek again. Little Mike Pekka against the Habs. Right along the ice. Beauty. Hey, finally, Lindy gets a little excited when this one goes in. Good to see. Bonda versus the Sabres. Hey, folks, watch this one. Went right through his glove. Well, Joey Juto ends the Sabres and Hasek's run in the playoffs. And Washington's off to the finals.
I'm often asked, what's the Hockey Night in Canada studio like? It looks so good, looks so big. Well, I hate to disappoint you, but come on in. We're right across from the Maple Leaf dressing room. Come in and take a look at it. And I don't want to let you down or anything, but take a look at this. This is our great studio. I understand in Air Canada Centre it's going to be better, but this has been here for years, 30 or 40 years, this has been it. And you know, at one time, this was a dressing room. This was the dressing room for the junior A hockey players, and this is where we're in here celebrating and everything like that. We won the OHA title right in here. Buffalo girl, are you coming out tonight? But I'm just a minute, is when I get through. Coming out tonight, they're killing it. Buffalo girl, you coming out tonight? Here I am again, dance by the light of the moon. Anyhow, they don't score, they don't hit. Well, I think you want to win.
How's my hair, Robbie? Is it okay to make it
look anyhow, beautiful? I mean, I just don't understand it. The Russian got mad at the little Swede there, pushed at the end, but nobody seems to get mad. I can't believe the shootout. The shootout should have been Gretzky, Recchi, Yzerman, Shanahan, and Eric. What the hell was the defenseman doing there?
But you know, the Americans were going to use Brian Leetch.
I don't care what the
Americans... Dave King used Jason Woolley in Elberville.
Dave King, excuse me.
Well, I mean, I am telling you... If you know you got a defenseman who's great on breakaways...
He's great on breakaways?
But you know, in practice, sometimes you find out a guy's...
Oh, I see. I'll tell you why they picked him, if you want to know why they picked him.
Oh, I know. Because the ice was heavy.
Wait a minute. The ice was heavy?
That was the reason.
Please. Please, don't insult my intelligence.
Well, that's what Mark Crawford said.
Just a minute. They picked him because he could knock plates out.
Yeah.
That's it. Well, Hasek wasn't a plate.
If I made you sigh, if I made you cry, I'm sorry. From the bottom of my heart, dear, I apologize. Didn't think I knew that, did
you? I can't believe you know it, but I'm glad to hear you finally. That's a man's man of the 90s. Can apologize. You know, when I started at Hockey Night in Canada, I'm not homophobic, but they got to me
homophobic
about my wandering eyes and stuff when I'm sitting next to you. And I just get a lot of people now expressing concerns. Bobby Orr, Dale Hunter, Doug Gilmore, Kirk Muller. Now the latest episode, let's just have a look at last week's Hockey Night in Canada episode.
Oh, yeah, you got that?
And here you are. We're just having a nice little chit-chat. Wayne was listening in. All of a sudden, you start blowing kisses again. This is how many guys now, five I've named, you've kissed, and now he kisses back.
Well, you know, you don't understand. You got a guy, tough guy, like Cash, you know, blowing me kisses, and Muller and that blowing me kisses. That's okay. But if it was a guy like you,
Give me a kiss.
You shut me up.
Whoa!
I thought this
Oh! All right. No way! Tough guys can do it. Guys like you can.
He's the best. Oh. Gotcha.
McCarthy's playing one of my favorites, McCarthy. Now, you must realize that hockey players like to, they want, one guy wants to be the last stop. Remember that time in Montreal? That,
Ed Hospodar, Chico Resch, and Claude Lemieux, and
well
Shane Corson.
Well done.
Thank you
very Anyhow,
much.
One of them goes off, and it's kind of a luck thing. Watch what happens. What do they call it? Rocks and papers and scissors and stuff?
Scissor, paper, rocks.
Go ahead, roll it now. Go ahead, Mark. Watch this here. If you think these guys aren't kids, watch this here now. They're like, he looks like, little black guy there. What a good-looking guy, I tell you. Darren McCarthy. And there's McCarthy. He's not going off, I'll tell you. Finally, he says, I'm not going off. Now, watch what he does. Watch. He looks. He takes his glove off, goes like this, goes like that, comes back, boom, boom, boom. Who wins? All right, you win.
You know how the game works. Well, count to three, and you go scissors, paper, or rock. And you know how that works? Scissors beats paper, paper beats rock, rock beats scissors. We'll just play the game. A little fun here going off. So one, two, three. You pick whichever one you want. Scissors,
I like
paper,
to go rock. Go ahead. All
okay.
Right. One, sorry.
One, two, three. Why, you go scissors. I can't believe you'd go scissors. I was sure you'd have rocks in your head. Don Cherry, the coach's corner.
Did I get sucked in there or what?
Don, we need you. I don't know what to say, ladies and gentlemen. What is this?
I've been out here a couple of days, and a couple of my friends, Sly and Arsenio, let me borrow a few things. Yes.
Bill Ranford's in goal. Don Cherry, in case you're wondering who it is.
Well, Billy surely be in, and he'll stand on his head because he's well-rested, and Grant needs a rest. I love the people out here. Look at them. Look at this floor director. The lovely people here. I love them. They're absolutely beautiful. They're gorgeous. Well built, and the way they walk, and that's just the guys, I'll tell you.
What's this got to do with the game? I think you've had a little too much sun,
well,
honestly.
I'll tell you, I'm out here, and I've been reading the papers, and I can see how people say they really don't want fighting here, and I can see that. The hot weather, the people, I can see why we shouldn't have hockey here with fights. Yes, I can see that.
Do you want to talk about any of the players involved in this classic?
Yes, I want to first of all talk about Kelly Rudy. Here comes Kelly right now. Here's Kelly right. He's coming in right now. And I love the little, he'll pick him up. I love the little blue string.
One more thing, my old defense partner, Bob McCammon. Okay, see what he said last week. This is for my grandson.
Just exhibition preseason, and we were playing the Quebec Aces. I remember we were leading with 2 minutes to go. He grabbed one of the Quebec Aces and gave him a pretty good thumping. And I said after the game, I said, Don, what did this guy do to you? He says, oh, nothing. He said, I just wanted to make sure I hadn't lost it over the summer.
Larry Walker, MVP, 22 votes out of 26, won the Golden Glove too. Kids, we are the best. Elvis, not bad.
Elvis Stoico, sure.
Villeneuve.
Todd Villeneuve's a good point.
Bailey.
Donovan Bailey, yes, world's fastest
Lennox
man.
Lewis, heavyweight champion.
Think he'll beat Holyfield?
That's a tough one. I got to think about that one. I don't know about that one. Looked pretty good his last fight. And the best of all, Shania, going for platinum too.
All the women in music right now are dominant.
Celine, or what's her name, Celine?
Dion.
Yeah.
And also Alanis Morissette.
That's
right. I don't know what it is. And Sarah McLaughlin could go on and on. Anyway, running out of time.
Anyhow, I love Shania. Now, why do I show Grant Marshall all the time? This is my third year in a row. The last time I saw Grant was in the St. Mike's Arena. I get a little emotional here. And he had a halo around. He had things dug into his skull and the whole deal. He had a broken neck. And he said, Grapes, I'm coming back. And I looked at him. I said, oh, boy. He had a little neck at the time and everything. This kid's never coming back. For all you kids in the hospital and all you kids that are hurt and you think you're never going to make it, you're in the bed now, things are running on you, just think of this guy with the halo on, with the things in his skull. He made it, and you can make it. Keep quiet at what it's about.
And despises no Don. And this is Don of the Coach's Corner on Molson Hockey.
I don't get enough time in this show. You know what I remember last year, folks, in the playoffs? I remember the Boston Bruins, the Washington Capitals, and I remember the overtime goal. I'll never forget it for Boston. Would have put them up 2-1 in the series. And Timmy Taylor had a little toe in. They called it back, and then the Boston Bruins lost. I never forgot that.
And you know, a wise guy, a very, very astute person, said something on TV. All you have to do is this. Put it back to the old size, take 3 feet off either size, keep the little bubble out in front so the guys don't come back and sit on the goaltender. They won't crash him. That's the way to do it. Do it, and you'll have somebody that's played the game and been in and around there. That's the way to do it. And you see, folks, they listened to me. But Pat Bird said, a year too late, Grapes.
Hey, it's a funny thing. They made the crease bigger to protect the goalies, and it didn't work that well, did it? You know, sometimes the goalies ask for it. Watch Dino and Martin go at it here. Tell you something, don't do that to Patrick. You're right, Patrick doesn't need anyone to protect him. Good shot. And look at Patrick, he can stick handle too. And look, he does the Bobby Orr spinorama. And what did I do? Some more great saves. Sometimes you need a little help from your friend. You know, folks, I bet you're wondering why I'm doing up here. Well, I'm going to tell you. You know, Around the benches, there's some awful foul language that's gone. I hate to say that, but it does go on. You know, in the heat of the game, you say things you shouldn't say. The players are yelling, and the fans hear it up here. So I was back of the bench here, and one time I heard this voice say, "Cherry, you got a filthy mouth." And I looked up, and it was a little old lady. She was about the age of my mother. Did I feel bad? So I came up here. This is while the game's going on. And I sat down and I says, "Rattel, I'm changing the lines for sitting up here." So there was a little pause and I said, "You know, ma'am," I put my arm around, "I do feel bad, but you've heard that language before, haven't you?" She says, "Yes, I've heard it before, but I didn't pay $60 to hear it." So I went down and I kept my mouth shut and I never swore after that. Now, I'd like to say something here, and this is the God's truth. If you go in the dressing rooms of the NHL, the American League, or the junior hockey, you'll hear bad language, there's no doubt about it. But I have never heard, and this is the God's truth, the Lord's name taken in vain. So kids, remember that. I'm not saying say the other stuff, it's bad enough saying it, but never take the Lord's name in vain. I'm telling you, the NHL guys don't. Now here are some of my favorite fans. Ron McLean, what are you kidding? Nice hat. Another nice hat. Yeah, you have to watch out for your own teammates while you're on the ice. Watch this one. Podine scores with a broken stick. I don't think it should have counted. That's what I like, hungry hockey players. Hey, watch New and Dyke Steel chase on stick. Ref, he's got my stick. Bill Garrett says, if I miss one more goal, I'm going to Edmonton. See ya, Bill. Pavel misses a wide open net and he can't believe it. Pavel says, that's it. I'm not coming back here next year. You can't score them all, Pavel. Trips over the blue line here. And now here's the old pie in the face gag. After a rousing speech, Essa hammers Ronnie Wilson with the pie. Ronnie says, hey, lemon meringue, not bad. Ronnie's not going to take that. Hey, we can't show that. Boy, is this embarrassing. Watch Olish score on his own net on a delayed penalty. This happened to me in Colorado, come to think of it. Hey, I don't know what he was thinking here. Look, he got a dead center. I don't know. You know, a lot of people ask me, whatever happened to the Boston Bruins the night that Darryl Sittler scored 10 points? Well, here's what happened. Rookie Dave Reese was in the net, as everyone knows. You know, Dave had a pretty good record. In 14 games, he had a record of 7-5-2. That's not too bad. And he had two shutouts and an average of 3.27. Hey, that's pretty good. But I'll tell you something. Every time the Leafs shot, it went in. Sittler was scoring from everywhere. You know, and a lot of people ask me, why didn't you put Jerry Cheevers in? Well, I remember him. He was at the end of the bench. And he put a towel over his head. I couldn't put Jerry in because he'd just come back from the WHA. I tell you, he didn't even have a practice with us, so I had to keep him for the next night we played Detroit in Boston. I had the Leaf pour Dave in the net, and the Leafs showed no mercy. It wasn't easy, I'll tell you, to watch Dave get hammered like that, but I had to leave him in for the good of the team. You know, I never forgot the Leafs pouring it on there, but let me tell you something. Later that year, the Leafs gave Sittler a silver tea set for murdering us like that. I got the paper, I cut out the picture, and every time we came to the Maple Leaf Gardens after that, I put this picture up of Sittler, you know, laughing and everything in the dressing room, showing the trophy and all that stuff and everything. And I said to the Bruins, remember, they show no mercy on us. And you know, folks, I'll tell you something. For the next 3 years, we never lost to the Leafs at the Garden. You know, this is a lesson for all you young coaches out there. Remember, it's not smart to embarrass the other team because someday it may come back to haunt you. Okay, folks, watch some of these beauty goals, starting off with the best guy of all, Stevie Wonder Yzerman. Watch some of these great passes. Isn't he something? Even while on his back. Now here's some nice ones by Mike Modano. Lovely. Boy, he's got soft hands. Now watch some of these one-handers, starting off with John LeClair. Now Courtnell gets into the act. The Oilers' Marchand gets one. Beauty slap shot. Wendell with a bullet top corner. Yammy gets a nice one. What a hot dog, though. Another Bobby Orr spinorama by Bertuzzi. Another spinorama by Boston Jason Allison. Corbet does a Joe Sakic impression. Now here's Gretzky with two classics. Oh, it's sad to see Patty LaFontaine retire. He's a great little guy. That's with a beauty. Top corner. Watch Al MacInnis skip a bullet past Chris. You know, you have to get out of the way so your goalie can see it. Boy, this was a tough bounce for Patrick. And now some more beauty hits. Those ones hurt, eh, Matthew? Now watch Maltby do his rag doll act. Boy, that's sickening. Peck again, dish it out. Can take it. What a guy. Eric, you gotta keep your head up with this guy on the ice. Look, he caught him right in the jaw. I know, folks, you won't believe this, but Ty got the only penalty on this play. I tell you, he's a marked man.
Folks, in Ty Domi's favorite home. I call it his home away from home. It's the penalty box, of course. And you know, of course, he's the most popular guy of the Leafs. And let me see, probably for his scoring. What do you think? No, you know what it's for. Now, him and Rob Ray are coming up. They have a little disagreement. If you don't want to watch it, hit the stop button. Too late. Let's go.
Rob Ray and Ty Domi. All right. Here they go. Now watch Ty. He's a left-hander, eh? He's tough. Always found a tough fight in those left-handers. Rob's right now. Look at him get the sweater over his head. See how he got a sweater over his head? But watch a little later. He lets him get the sweater off. Now he hits him a couple of shots. But watch now. He'll kind of tie it up a little and let him get his sweater off. Now watch. Go ahead. Get your sweater off. See? Get your sweater off, he's saying. Now he gets him up. There's a lot of honor going on there, I'll tell you. But I'll tell you, those left-handers are tough. Two tough guys going at it. That's it. Linesmen move in. Nothing wrong. Both laughing after. Watch, Ty goes to his bench. You. Look at Rob. He's not hurt. Linesman says, nice fight.
Ty comes over and says, pretty nice, guys. Point to his bench. Hey, lad, laughing. Nothing happened at all. Crowd going nuts. That's the way it should be. Here goes Ty, pointing at his bench. Pretty good, hey, guys? Love it. Nobody hurt.
Hey, folks, this is where the real fans sit, up here, nosebleed heaven. Well, I guess we gotta go, folks. All good things must come to an end like this building. This is a beautiful shrine, like I said. And you know how we're gonna end? With the best stuff in the last 10 years. See you later.
Hey, folks, here's some of the best hip checks from the last 10 years. Watch these guys fly. No matter what year it is, it's always a tough year for the coaches. This was in the playoffs in OT, and the Flames winning goal is waved off, and Terry Cripps goes nuts. The ref to see the replay. It was a tough night for Terry. The Kings went on to win the game. My buddy Pat Burns is sure mad at Melrose, and he lets them know it. Pat's not fooling around. Chuck Demers and Herb Brooks try to get at each other. Hey, Herb's just kidding, but Chuck's sure not. You gotta keep your head up even behind the bench. Right, Tom? As my buddy Danny Gallivan used to say, here's some more scintillating saves. Pat Roy. Wendell Young on Gretzky. Moog on Patty LaFontaine. Boy, that was in overtime. Peter Ng in the finals. What a beauty. Tommy Saucer, some on the Habs. Is that how you say it? Close enough. Eddie the Eagle on Fedorov. Osgood, a beauty on Sakic. Potvin, a nice one on Poulin. Potvin again on Kozlov. Cujo uses his head on Clark. Boy, that looked dangerous. Watch this one by Richter to save the Stanley Cup. Here's Kirk McLean with one of the biggest saves of all time in hockey. He makes the saves in double overtime to help the Canucks beat the Flames, and they go on to the finals. And now we have some of the best goals. Hey, I know this happened more than 10 years ago, but it's my tape and I'll do what I want. I still say this is the best looking goal ever scored. Now watch how he keeps his head down because he thinks he's embarrassed the other team. What a guy. Now watch some of these beauty goals by Denny Savard. Boy, this has got to be one of the best right up there, too.
Look at him out there. He looks like a little water bug. Here's some beauties by Mario. This one helps the Pens with the Stanley Cup. This one's in the finals too. Watch him blow by that defenseman. He had some of the softest hands I've ever seen. Now watch Wayne weave his magic. Stick on the ice, kid. Stick on the ice. This one breaks Gordy's record. How about some seventh game magic? The Leafs Borcheski scores to put out the Wings. Boy, are they happy. Now watch Pavel Bure bury the Flames. You know, they were down 3-1. They came back to win in the seventh game in overtime and went on to the finals. Now watch this beauty goal by Peter Klima. It's a great goal and a rotten helmet. Joe Sakic with some great goals when he was in Quebec. Pavel with a beauty. Now here's my buddy Darren McCarty with one of the prettiest Stanley Cup winning goals you'll ever see. Hey, it's not as pretty as Bobby's, but it's a beauty. And now, some of the best hits over the last 10 years. And here's Elise McCurry on Gretzky. What a hit, cutting along the blue line. You know, folks, he never ever played another shift in the National Hockey League after this. Now watch this beauty elbow on Chirla. He's a mean little guy. One of the best hits of all time, Stevens on Kozlov. Kozlov never stayed down, though. There's Scott Saint and Dino Cicerelli. You're next. Keep your helmet on tight. It's coming. Ulf Hammers Dig. Cousin Tina von Howitschek. Boy, that was a toughie. I'll tell you, folks, this one really hurt. I understand the goalie was saying it's okay, 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 all right, and here comes Clark, KO.
I have the hit of all time.
Yes, you do.
I do have the hit from Prince George, Corey Sarich on Quinn Hancock, Roll it right now. If you've seen a better hit, now watch the little Sue Eagles up there. Is that the hit of all time? I think we see it again, don't we? Can you believe Quinn gets up and gets two goals after this?
Lovely. Robert and McSorley. You know, folks, when I see these two guys fight, but they're going on and on here. And like I said in the earlier fights, you can't believe how tired they get. But you notice the small shoulder pads they have. They both had small shoulder pads. And there goes Marty's sweater again, even back in those days. See how Probert takes a couple to get ready. These are two heavyweights. They don't come any heavier than this, folks. And they don't come any tougher. Everybody, see, now let's see him let him get him up. He was down on his knees and he let him up. He could have hit him there. Boy, two warriors. Two of my buddies out the whole time they're fighting. I hope nobody gets hurt or broken jaw or something like that. See Marty switch over to the left hand. He can switch. Marty's cut right now. I thought the linesmen were going to move in a couple of times. Watch Marty say no. He said they're going to move in. They go to the movie. He says no. Let's go. Two warriors, I'll tell you. I never really thought it went on this far. Short ones. Bobby goes for the haymakers. Marty goes for the short ones. Boy, it's not fun to see them cut like that. But listen, after watch near the end, keep your eye on it. They tap one another on the head. Bobby taps them on the head. Watch, they go there. Two warriors. You go to war with these. See them tap heads? Pat them on the head. I'll tell you. Two of my buddies. You know who Bobby looks like? The Undertaker. There's Marty. Well, folks, we're going to end with some great plays, and thanks a lot for watching. We'll be right back.
Well, how did I start it again?
Yeah.
Well, folks, I guess all good things must come to an end, just like this tape and this. Bill Barocco, top corner on Jerry McNeil to win the 51. Boom. Okay, don't move, everybody. Well, folks, all good things must come to an end. And this beautiful shrine. No, you know, I like the first one first. I'm working at it now. You know what I mean? Is it good enough? Take a look at it. Play it. What is it, 1939? Oh. 31? Feel it in 31? No, I'll say the 30s. Bill it back in the 30s. Hey? Yeah, okay. One of the most famous goals of all time was scored right from this spot. Uh-oh. My wire's showing. That's okay. You know, I think it was Timmy Taylor had a little toe over here. It was in the... No, I got to get this. I'll get it going good. How is it so far? Now, you know, of course, he's the most... No, let me start again. If you could just get out of the way there. Good. Could you just get over the way? Yeah, good. And here we are. Tell me when. Folks, I'm telling you, right from this spot, Bill Barocco put it in the top corner of Jerry McNeil. I'll tell you, was that an exciting? I remember it. What a great shot. And I don't know how the photographer caught it. Rambling, eh? I'll just say he did it, eh? One of the most exciting games I remember here when I was coaching the Boston Bruins. Okay, hold on. Don't move. Don't anybody move their heads when I'm doing it, okay? Just stay soft. You know, a lot of people ask me... No. You know, a lot of people ask me that they... Phew. Right here on this spot, on this ice, Bill Barocco scored the one of the... Tell me when. You know what I remember last year in the playoffs? I remember the Boston Bruins scoring an overtime goal, and I remember they called it back, and Timmy Taylor was in the thing, eh? Yeah. You're gonna love it! Beauty! Let's go! Heads up! That's my repertoire.